Polling to vote for India's 15th president is underway. Facing off are the BJP-led NDA's candidate Draupadi Murmu and the joint opposition candidate Yashwant Sinha. A total of 4,809 members of the Electoral College comprising MPs and MLAs will elect the president. As of 2022, the Electoral College comprises 776 MPs and 4,033 MLAs. According to the Election Commission's directions, while MPs will get a green-coloured ballot paper, the MLAs will get a pink ballot paper to cast vote. Separate colours help the returning officer ascertain the value of vote of each MLA and MP. Today, let's tell you about the voting calculation process of presidential elections. The votes' value are determined by the population of each state as per Census 1971. The value of each MLA's vote varies from a high of 208 in Uttar Pradesh to a low of 7 in Sikkim. This means that Uttar Pradesh's 403 MLAs contribute 83,824 votes to the electoral pool, while Sikkim's 32 MLAs contribute 224 votes. The weighted votes from all the assemblies add up to 5.43 lakh. The process demands that 776 MPs, including 543 in Lok Sabha and 233 in Rajya Sabha, should contribute the same total of votes as the MLAs. Thus, the value of each MP's vote is 5.43 lakh divided by 776, rounded off to 700. And so the combined electoral pool from the assemblies and parliament adds up to 10.86 lakh. President Ramnath Kovind's five-year term ends on July 24th. And as per Article 62 of the Constitution, an election for the next president must be held before the completion of the incumbent's term. Presidential election results will be announced on July 21st. The 15th president of India will take oath on July 25th.